kids, it's Katie again and welcome back. Today we're going to be learning about popcorn and God, and we're going to be making yummy popcorn balls. So make sure you have an adult with you and let's get started.
Okay, all you will need is wax paper, a pan, caramel, chocolate, and most importantly, popcorn. Have you ever noticed that when popcorn pops, they don't all pop at once? There's not one big pop. Instead, there is a series of popping. And at the end, there are still some kernels that are not popped. God says in Ecclesiastes that there's a season for everything. So we pop at different rates. Some will pop sooner than others, while others are going through the process of being popped. Sometimes in life, you will see everyone around you going through things that you wish you can go through. Just because someone goes through something or pops before you doesn't mean you won't pop as well. Your time will come for you to turn into a beautiful piece of popcorn. Let's talk about the process of popping popcorn. In order for popcorn to pop, you need a small amount of moisture, heat, and a lot of pressure. So let's talk about the heat and pressure. Life heats you up, God is up to something good. Romans 8:28 says, "And we know that all things work together for the good of those who love God, to them who are called according to his purpose." Although life may seem hard, or you may go through some struggles, God will bring you out of everything. God wants us to turn to him during our times of trouble and rely on him. Next, we're going to talk about the water that is required to pop the popcorn. Without the moisture inside the popcorn, it will not pop. Although the amount of water is very small, it makes a big impact to form the popcorn. Think the amount of water like a mustard seed mentioned in Matthew 17:20. Jesus says that if we have faith the size of a mustard seed, we can move mountains. That small amount of faith has the ability to do big things. And when we come together as a body of believers, we have the faith to make even bigger things happen. Think of eating just one small piece of popcorn. It's delicious, but it doesn't satisfy. But compared to eating a big bowl of popcorn, your hunger goes away, and you are very happy. Imagine what a large amount of people with faith can do, and you have the power of faith at your side with God to do anything. When you look at popcorn, do you see that they all look a little different? Well, that's because each popcorn is very unique. God made each and every one of you to be different and unique as well. Although you may look like your family, God designed you to be very special and unique and possess your own talents and gifts. Some of you may have different gifts like serving or teaching, while others have the gift of prayer or creating things. You were formed in your mother's womb by God, and he made you perfect in his sight. Now that we've added something sweet to our salty snack, I want to talk about our perspective on life. A lot of times when bad things happen, we choose to be salty and dwell in the bad stuff. God wants us to think of the sweet things. We have the ability to shift our focus and change our perspective about the bad things in our lives to see all the good things. Although it may be hard to see good things when bad stuff is happening, there is a bright, positive side of things in every situation because of God. Romans 12:2 says, "Do not be shaped by this world. Instead, be changed within by a new way of thinking. Then you will be able to decide what God wants for you. And you will be able to do what is good and pleasing to God and what is perfect."
Well, thanks for watching. These popcorn balls are yummy and delicious, and I hope you enjoy them with your families. I hope you learned a lot about God today, and dig in, because I know I will.